Today, we are going to be looking at the biblical account on personal growth and development. What the Bible says on our personal growth and development. Before I begin to reveal to us from scriptures the biblical account of what personal development and growth is, first of all, let's look at what is personal growth and development. A quick one from Wikipedia says that personal development covers activities that improve awareness and identity and develop talent and potential, build human capital and facilitate employability, enhance the quality of life and contribute to the realization of dreams and aspirations. Alright, that's what personal development is about according to Wikipedia. Alright, from this brief definition of what personal growth and development is, we can see that our talents and gifts cannot be used optimally if we as a vessel, as human, upon which this talent and gift is deposited, is not positioned, is not ready, is not well equipped, is not well refined. Alright, so very quickly, there are three important personal growth and development aspects to consider for this sharing. The first aspect is improving of your self-awareness. The second aspect is discovering and developing your talent. And the third aspect is knowing and building your own identity. I take it again, the very first aspect of knowing about our personal growth and development is improving your awareness. Discovering and developing your talent is the second one. The third one is knowing and building your own identity. In order for us to be able to achieve our goals and dreams in life and be able to enhance the talent and gifts we have been endowed with by God, we need to work on ourselves. And this can be done by different ways. Different ways, alright? One of such ways is, first, we must be of sound mind and always resist the spirit of fear. One of the way we develop ourselves is to be of sound mind and always resist the spirit of fear. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. That we will see in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 6 to 8. And second, we must stay focused. We must stay focused. Because a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Not just in one way, in all of his ways. Therefore, we must stay focused. That we will see from the scripture in the book of James chapter 1 verse 7 to 9. A double-minded man is unstable in not just one of his way, in all of his way. So one of the ways by which we can develop ourselves according to the scripture is by staying focused. Alright. The word impossibility lies only in the dictionary of a foolish person. Nothing is impossible if only we can believe and take corresponding actions. Any time opportunity comes knocking, so it won't find us missing action. Third, don't overanalyze, because overanalysis can lead to paralysis. A paralyzed thought can always lead to unproductive results. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about his own self. So let's stop overthinking and let's stop worrying and being anxious. That we'll see in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 34. Then fourthly, we must be thankful and joyful. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. We see in the book of Nehemiah chapter number 8 verse 10. So as if we must develop ourselves, we must always be joyful and thankful. That's one of the things that the scriptures has makes us to understand. The fifth, we must learn to minimize murmuring and complaints. We must learn to minimize murmuring and complain. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose. Romans chapter 8, verses 28. We must minimize the murmuring and complaint. It must be minimized. Then, lastly, which is the sixth, we must read books on areas where we are struggling, areas where we are having weakness, areas of our weakness. We must read books on these areas, and we must make intentional commitment to remedy it. I, for one, have now personally decided to only consume content that tend to solve a problem in area where I am struggling with. So I also encourage you to begin to do same. All right.